Eventually, everything that you want will get to you. The question is, how long is it going to take for you to chill out and just start expecting good things to come? Conversations about things that take a long time cause more things to take a long time. Conversations about the ease of things cause more things to have the ease. In other words, here you stand as a receiver from the universe, and the way you feel determines how it comes to you. So if you've got strong desire for well-being and certainly deservability for well-being, and by well-being we mean physical well-being, we mean abundance, we mean clarity, we mean joy and love and all of the things that a good life means to all of you. We mean all of that. So here you stand with all of those things wanted and all of those things flowing to you, and to one degree or another you are allowing it to happen the hard way or the easy way. Every word you speak, every conversation that you have with someone else, every emotion that you feel is your indicator of whether you're making it harder for yourself or easier for yourself. And we think that what happens to you is because you've been approaching your life through action, where it feels to you like if you're gonna move, get that table someplace, then you're gonna get hold of it and you're gonna move it, and it's gonna take a certain amount of strength to move it. And that's the way you think things are happening, through your focus and through your action. And we want you to understand that while that moves tables from place to place, that's not what makes this universe work. What makes this universe work are these rivers and streams of energy flowing. And when you get in the flow of these strong streams, then all kinds of things work to your benefit, and otherwise they do not. So if we were standing in your physical shoes, we would go to bed at night acknowledging that tomorrow's a new day, and the next day we would get up and we would be determined to hold ourselves in as good a feeling place as we could. And when we would find ourselves on a run of appreciation, we would follow it all the way out. In other words, our singular intention would be to find a way of approaching any subject in the world in a way that feels good while we are doing it. Jerry used to ask, he asked us this question so many times because he was helping people financially. And first they'd lose the boat, and then they'd lose the car, and then they'd lose the other car, and then they'd lose the house, and they'd go all the way to the bottom, and then things would bounce back and turn around for them. He saw it over and over and over again, and he said, why do they have to go all the way to the bottom before things turn around? Why couldn't they just lose the boat and it would turn around? Why couldn't they just lose the boat in the first car and it would turn around? Why do they have to go all the way to the bottom before it turns around? And we said, because it isn't until it goes all the way down that most people give up the battle, that they just finally say, all right, I give up, I let go. It's a letting go of the belief that you're making it happen through your actions, and it's an accepting that you are deserving of it. We think it's because of the comparison that you make with each other, and you're wanting to prove your own worthiness by discounting theirs. And every time you discount somebody else's worthiness, you diminish your own. You've got to be a well-wisher for them too, you see. When you're in this competitive spirit where you're trying to outdo somebody else in your attempt, and you're pushing against them, you're actually pushing against you. So there's this just sort of letting go of all of it. What it really is an acceptance. You are good. Good is coming to you. You deserve the good that is coming. Give up the battle. Give up the struggle. Give up the competitiveness. Give it all up and accept the goodness that is in your vortex. Let it flow into your experience by loving that tree, by loving that toad, by loving that lizard, by finding something simple that doesn't get you all wadded up. It's like rewiring yourself.
So in other words, whatever I want, whatever my intention is, I should just put it out there and not get hung up on details.
It's easier than that.
Yeah.
You don't have to put your intentions out there. They just go out there.
Okay. Okay.
There's no putting them out there. They're out there. If you live in a house with not enough closets, more closet goes in your next house. In other words, it's just the way that it works. Your intentions.
So the way to speed up a manifestation is to just get rid of all resistance.
The way to speed up manifestation is to slow down resistance. So how do you cause something to stop increasing in your vibration? How do you stop it from increasing? You take your attention from it, because this is a universe based on inclusion. There's no exclusion. You can't say no. You go, you come, and you go. Because what you're actually you that I want come to me, and you that I don't want go away. They both come. Because attention is attraction. So you have to cease the attention. So how do you stop thinking about something? By thinking about something else, or by going to sleep, or by meditating. You can quiet your mind when you meditate. If what you're thinking doesn't cause you to feel good, then you've got to find some way to break the evil cycle, so to speak.